Hello everyone, welcome back to channel. Welcome back to another tutorial video. It's a pretty simple Shopify trick which I'm gonna tell you guys. So the reason why I'm creating this video is you guys, because I have been receiving a lot of comments on our channel about creating this simple video, because there's just nothing in that video. It's just to check mark on one of the settings in Shopify. And in this video, we will learn how to add customer account icon, how to basically enable customer account icon, and if it's not showing up on your store. So as you can see that on my screen, I don't have that customer account icon showing up. But if I go to this tab, I have this customer account icon showing up. So basically what I'm going to do in this tutorial is walk you through where you need to go in settings to enable that. And additionally, I'll be teaching you guys how you can add the custom account info icon. So if you don't like the basic look of this icon, by watching this video, you will not only enable that, but will also be able to customize it to make it looking good and to match it with your color scheme, to match it with the rest of your theme. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, because that's the only thing which we are asking from you guys in order to make more valuable content for you guys. Okay, without further ado, let's just get into it to enable our customer account info icon. Okay, so as you can see, if I hit refresh, I don't have this icon showing up. So all we have to do is just go back to the backend of our Shopify development store by navigating to /admin. And here we have our dashboard showing up. So if you're already logged in, you will see a dashboard like this. So all you have to do is just click on settings on the left hand menu. And then from settings, click on customer accounts from the left hand menu again. And then as you can see, it's currently hidden. Customer accounts are hidden. So all we have to do is just click on edit and then click on show link, login link in the header of online store and at checkout, right? So just check mark it and then hit save. And here we go. Our customer account login icon will be showing up now. So all you have to do is just hit refresh a couple of times, because it might take a minute or two in order to display. And here we go. As you can see, our customer account info icon is showing up now. Now the next step in which I'll show you guys how to add the custom account info icon, and it's also pretty simple. So first let's go to svgrepo.com, where we will find the SVG icon, whatever we like. Again, this video is not a promotional video. I'm not promoting svgrepo.com. I would love to have sponsorship if they ask me, but currently it's not a sponsorship video or any affiliated video on that. I just like searching the SVG icons from this website, and I'm sharing that with you guys. So we will search user, or we can also search account. And as you can see, we have different icons showing up, which we can use here. So let's try using that one. Okay, now I'll download this SVG vector by clicking on this download SVG vector button, and then we'll open this file in my code editor. So I'm going to open my Visual Studio Code and then open the file which I downloaded. So just go to this icon here, click on open, and that's the SVG code. Now we'll have to copy this code in our theme. And now let's go back to our theme. Click on online store. And here we have our Dawn latest version activated. So as of now, it's 12.0.0. I don't know when you guys will be watching this video, so it might be updated by the time you're watching this video, but it should be working on all of the versions. Okay, now let's click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing any code, make sure to have a backup of your theme. In case you add the code wrongly, you can easily revert it back. Okay, click on edit code, and then we will search for customer account. Let's search for account. Here we go. So we have this icon-account.liquid file. And when we open this, you can see that we have SVG code showing up. Now all we have to do is just go back to our code editor, copy the code and paste on our icon-account.liquid file. And that's it. Now I'm going to hit save. And now let's preview our store. Make sure to wait for a minute or two because it takes a little bit time sometime. So I'm going to click on preview store. And now as you can see, my customer account icon is showing up differently. So that's the default icon. And that's the icon which we added additionally to customize it. You can add in some CSS code to adjust the sizing. Let me show you how you can do that. So you can simply click on inspect. And then we can do some styling here. So as you can see, we have this height here showing up. We can reduce the height. So let's add in here 4 rem and width 4 rem. Now let's try reducing it more to match with the cart icon. That looks much better, right? Now, in order to add in the size, we will copy this class. So this header underscore underscore icon is responsible for all of the icon sizes, right? But we need to just change our account icon size, customer account icon size, right? So we will need to find the appropriate class for that. And let's search. So guys, there's no class showing up on our customer account SVG icon. And in order to resize it, we'll have to add an additional class to our SVG code. So that's the code which we added, and we will add a new class so we can style it by adding new CSS account icon new. Okay, now when we have our class, sorry for the misspelling here, and we will also open up base.css file where all of the CSS of the theme exist. So what we're gonna do, we will add some styling by calling this class, right? Now click on save first. And now once I refresh here, you can see the class is equal to account-icon-new is showing up. Now we need to make it the same size as our cart icon. Now let's see what's the proper size for that. Let's height or width. Okay, height 3 rem and width 3 rem looks fine. Now in order to add in this size, we can add the code in the newly created class. So first just add in the height and width which we added, which we need to add, and now we will add the code. What was the class? Okay, account icon new. So just copy the class, go to base.css, and we will target this class and add our code. And hit save. So what we did is added an additional class on our SVG icon, which we downloaded from svgrepo.com. And now we are adding CSS to make it look similar or make it look same as size in the cart icon, just like the cart icon, right? And in base.css, we defined the height and width. Now let's go back to the store and hit refresh. And now you can see the size is the same as the cart icon, a little bit different, but you can adjust it with the CSS. The reason why I showed you guys, because you guys might have different theme, or you guys might want to use a different SVG icon for customer account icon. So you can simply customize it by adding additional class and adding some CSS code. So that was the default size. So when I remove height and width, you can see that's the default size. But after adding the CSS, we have this showing up it like this. Okay, guys, I think it's good enough for you guys to understand how to enable the customer account info icon on your Shopify store, how to customize it, and how to resize it using CSS. That's it for the tutorial, guys. Let me know if you want more in-depth tutorial related to CSS or anything related to Shopify, WordPress, or in general web design and development. We are expanding our team of creators, so hopefully in few months you'll be seeing more videos in this channel related to video editing, related to website design and development, related to Figma, Elementor, lots of stuff which we are planning to add in this channel. And all we request from you guys is subscribe to us, comment on the video below, and let us know what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.